Today I'd like to discuss how the way that atoms are arranged in a solid can change the behavior of that solid. We'll start by doing an experiment. I'll drop these two ball bearings down these tubes and watch them bounce off the metal plates. As you can see, one bounces much longer than the other. So what's the difference? Both ball bearings are the same, but the bases are different. This base is made of stainless steel, while this is stainless steel with a thin disc of amorphous metal glued firmly to the top. The stainless steel base has many pits in it from the ball bearing, whereas the amorphous metal base is smooth. Well, the stainless steel base is a crystalline material. That means that the atoms in it are arranged very regularly. When the ball bearing hits, these atoms can slip past each other. Think about bouncing a basketball into some sand. When the ball bearing hits, all of its energy goes into moving the atoms. On the other hand, in the amorphous metal tube, when the ball bearing hits, none of the energy is dissipated. That's because amorphous metal is made out of many different types of atoms of different sizes. These metals are quickly cooled before they can crystallize. Therefore, they're essentially gridlocked. Amorphous metal has many different uses. For example, amorphous metal has been used in golf clubs to make the golf ball fly farther. Another example is in the Genesis spacecraft, which was sent to collect solar wind. Tiles to collect the wind were made out of amorphous metal. The Genesis spacecraft actually crash-landed on Earth, but the tile survived.